This will be the first part of my attempt at running through King's Quest VI. It's been a little while since I've played. I played a test of it the other day, but this will be my first time playing it from beginning to end. And I don't know, a year or two, something like that. But yes, I guess I should just go ahead and jump in it. So this is Alexander, Prince of Daventry. He came searching for his love, Cosima, and wound up here on the shore. As you can see, is shipwrecked. So let me go over here and get his ring.
Alexander picks up his royal insignia ring from the beach.
Something over here as well.
Alexander pushes the plank to one side. A box has been partially buried under sand.
Now, I will not be talking quite as much as I normally would playing a game, because there's so much dialogue in this game. But I will try to pause and say some stuff every so often. That way it's not as boring for everyone.
Alexander takes the coin and leaves the ruined box where it is.
All right. And now it's time to take off. Let me go this way. All right. So there's two paths. The one on the left will take me to the town, where it has a pawn shop, a bookstore, and the lamp dealer. And then the one on the right takes me to the castle. So since I'm looking for Cosima, I'm going to go to the right. Dogs. Literally. You gotta love puns.
Alexander politely addresses the odd-looking guards at the castle doors, hoping to learn more about his predicament.
Good day to you, guards. I was cast upon this island in a storm, and I'm a little confused about my location. Could you tell me what place this is and who lives in this castle?
Prince Alexander.
Hey, what did that you say? A castaway? A likely story. We haven't had any foreigners in this part since Alhazred arrived.
Don't be so rude, Gruff. He's not asking for any secrets. You're standing on the Isle of the Crown, lad. And this is the Castle of the Crown. The royal family resides here. Rather, what's left of the royal family.
The Isle of the Crown? But tell me, am I anywhere near the land of the Green Isles?
This is the land of the Green Isles. The Isle of the Crown is the main island, foolish boy.
Then Princess Cosima must live in this very castle.
Aye, the princess is indeed our treasure jewel to guard, and we consider it an honor.
Let me talk to them again.
Excuse me, guardsmen, guard dogs. I've been traveling for months to see Princess Cosima. I would like an audience, please.
I'm sorry, but the princess is not receiving visitors, particularly not strangers.
Let me show them my ring.
Alexander decides to show his royal insignia ring to the Castle of the Crown guards. With all of his papers lost in the shipwreck, it is the only possible calling card he can think of.
Good day. I'm Prince Alexander of Daventry. I'm an acquaintance of Princess Cosima. If you could just inform her that I'm here, please.
Heh, so everyone says. Let me just look at that ring.
What does it say, Gruff?
Yeah, what does it say?
Kingdom of Daventry? Prince Alexander. Wait here while I go see what Captain Saladin thinks of this.
You get him out here. I demand it.
The guard returns a moment later with a majestic-looking creature. Captain Saladin speaks with a voice that is gentle, but reflects a will of iron.
Prince Alexander of Daventry, I presume. I'm afraid I'm unfamiliar with your country, but I'm sure Wazir Alhazred will want to meet you, if indeed you are a friend of the princess. Please, follow me. Lord Alhazred, a visitor to see you. Prince Alexander of Daventry.
Yay!
What is it that you seek, Prince Alexander?
Pardon the intrusion, my lord, but I came to see Princess Cassima. Some months ago, my father, King Graham, saved my family and I from imprisonment under an evil wizard named Mordak.
As previously
the
played
same wizard
in King's
that
Quest
kidnapped
V.
The princess?
Exactly. When my father rescued us, he also liberated Cassima and sent her home.
Then your father has my gratitude, and that of the entire kingdom. But I'm afraid I still fail to see the purpose of your visit.
Well, I came to make sure that Cassima arrived safely and to pay my respects. Before we parted, she gave me an invitation to visit.
I have no doubt she did exactly that at the time, Prince Alexander. However, things have greatly changed for Cassima since her ordeal in Mordak's castle. Cassima's parents both became ill and died while she was gone. Cassima is sequestered in mourning for them as befits a princess. She is not receiving visitors of any kind.
Any kind.
Even if she were, I do not think your visit would be appropriate. You see, it is time for Cassima to take her responsibilities seriously. With her parents gone, she no longer has the luxury to be a carefree maiden. As was her parents' wish, Cassima and I are to be wed. We shall rule the kingdom together. I assure you, our marriage is all Cassima wants now.
He's such a
As a prince and a gentleman, it would be best that you leave before there is any further embarrassment.
Embarrassment?
I see.
God, what
I
a
suppose
douche.
That I was mistaken. I thought for certain that Cassima... Well, I apologize.
A young man sees what he wishes to see. I'm sorry you've wasted your time traveling to the land of the Green Isles. May your journey home be swift.
Now, perhaps I will take the opportunity to look around your fair land while I'm here.
I would advise against that. The kingdom is rather, shall we say, inhospitable these days. But it is your neck. You may risk it if you please. Captain Saladin will escort you from the castle. Good day.
Now, if you pay attention to the one in the middle, his eyes glow gold, and you'll see him quite a bit through the whole
game. You have
game
had your hearing with Wazir Alhazred. I trust you'll respect his wishes and not return. I have been instructed not to let you into the castle again. Good day, my lord.
Captain Saladin whispers something to the guard dogs at the castle gate, and they nod with understanding. Alexander has a feeling they won't be letting him into the castle again.
All right, now it's time to go to the town. I could, well, yeah, I'll go ahead and talk to them real quick again.
Please, if you'll only be reasonable, I really must see the princess.
Be gone! You're not welcome at the castle, Prince Alexander of Daventry. We have our orders, and they are quite clear.
And What are those orders?
Please, if you'll only be...
Be gone!
Okay, never mind. This is repeating. Now it's time to go to the town. See, the Nightingale is not here yet. Okay. I will go. Okay, rule of thumb. When, anytime you go to the town.
Old lamps for new! Oh. Old lamps for new!
Funnily enough, when I was growing up, I played this game so many times, my dad would just start saying that randomly. Anyway, whenever you go into the town...
Old lamps!
Whenever you go into the town, as a general rule of thumb, go to Ali's books first before going to the pawn shop. There may be some things you need...
Old lamp!
Yes, sir. In the pawn shop first, but always go to Ollie's books just in case Jallo shows up. He's the jester of the
old lamp
castle. Somebody cleaned out their chamber pot. Ew. But here at the beginning, it doesn't really make
Hello.
A difference which one you go into
first.
I
will be right up. Now, what can I do for you?
First off, I'm gonna grab this, boring book.
Alexander picks up the book from the small table.
Oh, yes, please, take that book. You have my most humble thanks for doing so, good sir.
Really? Thanks!
And this is why. I'm gonna read it real quick.
Alexander opens the bargain book and reads a paragraph at random.
Two dulcimers raised to the degree of 40 half dulcimers, divided into equal parts by the third of a cackle of grouse geese, put over the result of 10 fine mackles, albeit small fine mackles, stretched over the total of 53 and an eighth bottles of wild beast lard.
Yeah. Yep.
Phew. What an incredibly boring book. No wonder the bookshop owner wanted to get rid of it so badly.
Alright. Now, this is the book that Jallo likes to read.
Alexander rests his feet for a moment. Alexander picks up and leafs idly through a book called The Changing Role of Court Entertainers Through the Ages. Well, that was refreshing.
All right. I'll look at this book over here.
How much for that book on the counter, merchant?
Doodling.
It is a fine book, is it not? I obtained it from the estate of the one and only magician this kingdom has ever had. Poofed himself into an aardvark in the end, or so I heard. I never found the spells all that useful myself, but then I lead a boring life. I tell you what, if you can find another rare book, something a bit more marketable, I might be willing to exchange the spell book for it.
Well, first off, I'm going to look over here on the bookshelf.
Thinking of Cosima, Alexander decides to leaf through one of the volumes of love poetry.
I know these.
He reads.
Well, at least two.
Thy hair, thy lips, thy beauteous face, and all thy studied female grace
have won for thee anon a place within this broken breast. And I recite that at Renfair's all
and
the
another.
Time.
Upon the shore the lilies
this one
bend,
I don't know as
untouched
as much.
By worldly care, where shadow they her earthly bed, Oh, that she were not there. Yikes.
Now the and third another. One.
What was it when I looked at you?
What power has chained me through and through and binds my heart with links so tight I cannot live without the sight of you? What nameless thing has captured me and made me powerless to flee? What thing is it without a name that brings my mind ever back the same to thee? The name of love cannot apply. Its commonness does not decry the haunted, haunted, painful cry that my heart makes for you, that ere my soul eternal makes for you. Yes, I have that memorized.
A little close to home, that one.
Alexander returns the love poem book to the shelf.
Recited that one at Rumm Fairs, too.
Alexander picks up the fallen page. It's the love poem he particularly liked. It must have fallen out of the poetry book.
I see that old volume has lost another page. You may keep it if you like, sir. I have glued the stubborn thing back in place 2 times already.
I do rather like it. Thank you, merchant.
All right, let me talk to Ali real quick.
Good day, sir. I'm a stranger in this land. What can you tell me about the land of the Green Isles?
That is quite a question, young man. Who are you, and what would you have me tell you?
My name is Alexander. I know I'm on the Isle of the Crown, but I'd like to know whatever you can tell me about this island, and if there are other islands nearby.
You are indeed a stranger. Anxious is the man who knows not the customs of the land beneath his feet. This island is called the Isle of the Crown, because the royal family's castle is here. Besides the castle, we also have this village and the docks over to the west. There are at least 3 other islands. The Isle of the Sacred Mountain.
At least 3?
The Isle of the Beast. And the Isle of
Wonder.
Do you
not know of any more?
At least 3? Does no one know for certain?
Oh, that's what it is.
This is no ordinary land, Alexander. The land of the Green Isles has always been a place of vague boundaries, as if islands come and go. Legend speaks of a 4th island, an isle shrouded in mists. I myself have never seen it. Then, too, the land of the Green Isles is said to exist on the boundaries of this world and the next. Even darker places are reputed to be closer here than anywhere else in the world.
That's quite a claim.
Claim, yes. But probably just local superstition. We who live here on the Isle of the Crown, at least, sleep well enough at night.
Those first 3 islands you mentioned, how might I learn more about them?
All right, watch his mouth.
Ideally, a young man seeking such knowledge would travel to their shores and learn about them firsthand. Meeting the leaders of each place would be helpful, naturally.
You'll never unsee that now.
Unfortunately, the ferry no longer runs between the islands. There has been much political unrest, and it has been too dangerous to travel for years. Perhaps the ferryman can tell you more. He has little enough to do these days. And if you haven't been there already, you might seek an audience at the castle.
Thank you kindly, merchant, for all your good advice.
Ah, but advice is free, Alexander. Making use of it costs much more.
All right, if you're just joining me, I'm attempting to make a perfect run of King's Quest VI. Of course, I'm not going to play it all at once, but so far I've got 14 of 231. Last time I played this, let me talk to the genie real quick.
Good day, sir.
The mysterious old man just ignores Alexander.
Last time I played this, I forgot to do one thing, and that cost me. But this time, I remember what it was, so I'm going to attempt to go for the perfect score again. Alright, I will go to the ferryman first, before going to the pawn shop. And I'm going to go over here so I can let this play out.
Roses! I've told you a million times, those flowers are too sweet for the likes of you! You've still got to do the breakfast dishes, make lunch, and clean the stables yet this morning! And get your veil back on! No one wants to look at your face!
Yes, stepmother.
So, not only is she beauty, she's also Cinderella. And there he is! Just for fun, I'm...
Hey, stranger! Come join me! The water is wonderful, and I can show you the way to the next island!
Okay, just for fun, every time I see the genie, I'm gonna do what he wants me to do. But I'm gonna save it first, just to be safe. And... yeah. Here, I'm gonna save it as this. Save. Let him talk again.
Come on, jump in! A little water won't hurt you!
Alright, now that I got it saved.
Considering the poor condition of the shore, it looks like the easiest way to get into the water is just to jump off the pier. The powerful currents grab Alexander. Struggle as he might, he feels himself being pulled out to sea.
Not a very good swimmer, are you?
Help me!
Sorry, I think not.
As his head submerges for the third time, Alexander finds himself pondering the wisdom of going out on a limb for a stranger.
Tickets up next.
Alexander couldn't handle those currents. That boy must be an unbelievably strong swimmer.
All right, now I'm going to go back to where I was. There we go. Yeah, so...
Come on, jump in! A little water won't hurt.
I'm gonna do what he wants me to do every time I see him.
What are you waiting
for? Whoops. There we go.
That's strange. The young boy in the water just disappeared. Oh well, perhaps he just dove under the water.
Perhaps.
What do you want?
Alexander.
Nope.
Excuse me. My name is Alexander. The owner of the bookshop in the village told me you might be able to help me. I hear you used to run this ferry for the islands. I'd like to talk to you if you have a moment.
You say old Allie sent you? I can't see why. The ferry's not running, you know.
I understand. I'd just like to talk to you about the islands if you don't mind.
Well, I guess it'd be all right if Allie sent you. Well, don't just stand there. Come on inside.
I never did understand this. The dude's so bored out of his mind.
About, young man?
But he acts like a dick to anybody unless Allie sends him.
I see you have a rabbit's foot. Has it brought you much luck?
As you can see, my luck's been out for some time now, despite that old charm. Why don't you take it with you? Perhaps giving the darn thing away will bring me good fortune at last.
Perhaps it will at that. Thank you.
Alright, now they got a second part of the, No, just one. Okay, yeah, there's five parts I need to get past the guards of the Isle of Wonder. And that makes one of them.
I'm a visitor to these islands. I'd like to learn what I can about the area.
Boop.
So you said outside. What is it you want to know?
Well, for one thing, Why has the island's only ferry been dry docked?
Huh. It just ain't safe to sail these days. What with the island's feuding and all. Wazir Alhazred ordered the ferry closed till things settled down. Me? I don't think she'll ever see water again.
But why are the islands feuding?
You got me. Something about stolen property or some such thing. 'Tis a real shame. Things used to be so friendly.
Then this unrest is recent.
A few years is all, but it's been long enough.
Perhaps if the ferry were repaired.
This old thing? This ferry's been out of water so long she's no longer even seaworthy. Her boards have dry rot. She'd fall apart at the first taste of seawater.
But there must be some way to get off this island.
There's only one other way to travel that I know of. A magic map. The owner of the pawn shop can tell you more about that than I can, Alexander.
Alright. That's all I need, but... should I just listen to his tales or just leave? I'm just gonna leave. Yeah, screw it.
Well, I think I'll be going now. Thanks for allowing me into your home.
Posh, not at all. It breaks the boredom, if you know what I mean.
So bored off his ass, but he's a dick to anybody that shows up unless Ollie sends him. Alright, now I know where the map is. The pawn shop. Wait. Oh.
Alexander season.
That's right. I have to go in here first. Because Jello.
Good day again. How may I help you?
Because if I go in the pawn shop first, then he won't be here.
Good day, sir. Is there anything you can tell me about the land of the Green Isles?
I'm sorry, but I have no time for idle conversation. I'm too worried about the princess.
Now I can keep talking to him, or I can just go ahead and give him the ring.
Determined to learn more about the strange man's relationship with the princess, Alexander shows the man his insignia ring and formally introduces himself.
I'm sorry to insist, but my name is Alexander of Daventry, and...
I appreciate the offer of the ring, Alexander, but I'm afraid I'm already spoken. Daventry? Where have I heard of Daventry? Flying flitmice, you must be Prince Alexander. Cassima told me about you when she arrived home. How came you here?
Why, by a ship, now wrecked upon the sand. But you know Cassima? She truly spoke of me?
Yes, I saw her briefly when she first returned home. She mentioned a prince to me, the Prince Alexander of Daventry. I'm afraid that was before she was told about her parents' deaths. You see, she arrived home a few weeks too late. The king and queen thought they'd never see her again. It is said they died of heartbreak. I'm afraid she's blamed herself.
What a terrible homecoming. If we had only known...
Terrible indeed, poor thing. Everyone in the kingdom seems to despair with her these days. The streets are silent.
Where is she now?
The princess is sequestered in mourning. It's a rather dated tradition, and not required, but the wazir says she insisted out of respect.
I see. You've yet to say who you are. And how you know the princess?
I? Oh, pardon me. My name is Jallo. I am clown to the royal court, and have been since the marriage of Cassima's parents, King Caliphim and Queen Alaria. Oh, those were the happy days. The pair of them were so full of joy and life.
Sunday, so Monday, love. Happy days.
And Cassima's birth. It would be hard to explain how long they had waited. How they had hoped for a child. I mean, she was such a charming little thing.
Smart as a whip. Kind and sweet. Oh, she means everything to this kingdom, Alexander, and to me. I'm so terribly worried about her.
About her grief over her parents, you mean?
Well, the truth is, I do not trust the Wazir or his plans for Cassima. I'm still living at the Castle of the Crown as court clown, his clown. But it is more to keep my ear to the ground than out of loyalty. I wish I knew what the princess thinks these days. If only I could find Sing Sing, Cassima's pet nightingale. I might be able to send the princess a message. As it is, I must wait for the end of her seclusion. Now I'm afraid I must hurry back to the castle. I'll try to return to the bookshop again later.
Thank you for speaking with me, Jallo. I hope we meet again soon.
And that's all I need from in here so far. Until I get to the Isle of Wonder. Now I can go to the pawn shop.
Good day!
Good day! Here's the genie again. Shamir Shemazel.
Alexander takes a mint.
That's number two item that I needed. So let me go ahead and... Actually, let me just talk to him real quick.
Excuse me, merchant. But the ferryman mentioned that you might have a magic map of the land of the Green Isles.
Why, as a matter of fact, I do. I keep it under the counter. It's been gathering dust so long that I nearly forgot about it. It was quite a few years ago, you see. The estate of a wealthy wizard fell into my hands when he died. It was useless magical junk mostly, which reminds me, I've still got some things of his in the back that I need to dump out. Anyway, the magic map was the one true treasure in the lot. The wizard was quite old and feeble and had enchanted the map to aid in traveling. It is said that one need only desire to be on an island depicted on the map to find oneself there. It is a very valuable map, as you can imagine. Unfortunately, no one is interested in traveling these days. It is far too dangerous with the current state of the kingdom.
I'll travel.
What would you take for the map?
I would normally want something magic in return, but since I am hardly overrun with prospective buyers, I would be willing to take anything of equal value in exchange.
Ah, the Ring of Daventry.
Would you be willing to take my family ring in exchange for the magic map?
Daventry, are you a king then?
No, that's my father, King Graham. I'm just Alexander.
His last name's Cracker.
Well, Prince Alex, she is a beautiful ring. Are you sure you can part with such a unique family heirloom?
The ring does mean a lot to me. I didn't always have a family.
Does that make him Prince Alexander Cracker?
Still, it is only gold. There are more important things at stake now.
Then you now own a magic map, Prince Alex. I will keep your ring out of sight for a few days. If you find anything else of great value in your travels, you can come back for your ring. I would hate to see it melted down for gold. Ah, and a warning about the map. It will only operate when you are out in the open and within sight of the sea. The limitation has something to do with the teleport spell ingredients. You might try the beach.
Thank you. You are very kind. And I'll remember about the map.
And here comes the genie. He gets drunk
suddenly,
on mints.
The old man in the concealing cloak sneaks past Alexander, and with a sneaky dart of his hand, steals a mint from the candy jar. The old man stuffs the mint into his mouth and wobbles unsteadily out of the pawn shop.
The magic smack.
Master! I follow Prince Alexander as you wished.
from the pawn shop owner. He just abstained. Just reprieved. He just got a magic map.
You fool. You've been eating those mints again. I ordered you to stop that.
Yes. Master.
Now, what is this about a magic map?
With a map, Prince Alexander could travel anywhere as quickly as I can.
I thought I took care of the only means of travel. By my scimitar, I can't have him stirring things up now. Get a hold of yourself and listen carefully, Shamir. Go to the other islands and tell them...
All right, here we go. We get the,
I have this copper coin. Is it of any value to you at all?
Most interesting. I have never seen a Daventry coin before, but it is copper genuine enough. I might even find a buyer who is interested in foreign currency. The items on the front counter are the only things in the store that I can let go for the price of one copper. You may make your choice from there.
Alexander looks at the items on the counter to make his selection.
Nightingale.
That mechanical nightingale looks intriguing. I believe I'll take it.
Very well. Your coin is well spent. Remember, this is a pawn shop. I am always willing to take back my own goods in trade.
I'll remember. Thank you.
All right, now I can continue on. All right, two things. First, I'm gonna go back into town because that.
Alexander sorts through the odds and ends that the pawn shop owner dumped into the pot. Magic exploding gum wrappers, a shattered crystal ball, a cracked wand, a fake thumb. Near the bottom, Alexander finds a little glass bottle labeled ink. It appears to be empty, but Alexander decides to take it anyway. You never know when a small bottle will come in handy.
Alright, that gives me four items. Now I just need the flower. Alright. Since Sing Sing's here.
Alexander winds the mechanical nightingale and places it on the ground. The mechanical nightingale sings a sweet, tinny tune. The real nightingale in the tree cocks her head and listens intently. The nightingale flies to a lower branch and looks at Alexander curiously, as if she were deciding that this human might not be so bad.
All right. Before I do this, I'm gonna save it. Let's see. Save it as a note to Sing Sing. All right. Now, I know I'm supposed to give it to her, but I can't remember if I'm supposed to do this first or the ring first, so I'm going to try this and see what the points are.
Alexander holds out the love poem to the nightingale, hoping that she perhaps is the nightingale that Jallo spoke of, and that she might be able to take the words of love to her mistress, Cosima. The nightingale swoops down and grabs the poem. she flies off towards the castle. Perhaps to Cosima?
Yay!
Sing Sing, what have you found? A scrap of paper? Oh, this is no mere bit of paper, but words of love. Who sent this? It must have been Abdul. Oh, Sing Sing, will he never give up? You must be careful, pretty bird. Stay away from Abdul. I don't trust him so close to you. Now go!
The little bird returns to her branch without the poem. Alexander wishes he knew what happened to his message of love.
All right, now I know that I'm not supposed to do it yet. Because if I do give it to the Sing Sing with or after the ring, I know that I get a note back, and that adds to my points. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my ring back. First off, do this.
Alexander pulls out his magic map. Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Let me talk to the little oyster over here.
Why aren't you asleep like the other oysters?
Oh, I'm so weary, but I can't sleep. I have a terrible ache in my mouth.
Time to use the boring book.
If you're having trouble sleeping, perhaps you'd like me to read to you.
Hey, that would be great!
Two dulcimers raised to the degree of 40 half-dulcimers, divided into equal parts.
Right. Alexander sees nothing of interest on that part of the oyster.
Yields a gilded...
There it is.
Alexander makes a grab for the pearl.
Hey! You fixed my mouth! It feels great!
The little oyster drifts into peaceful slumber with the rest of his oyster friends.
All right. I don't have all the pieces that I need to continue on here. I can either wait for this note to come up, which I'm not sure how long it... Oh, here it comes. Just a little more. While I'm waiting for that, the note here says, where are you going? And I need to talk to the dangling participle. Oh, here it is. On the Isle of the
Alexander
Beast.
Picks up the object floating in the water. It appears to be a string of letters. They say, where are you going? Alexander decides to keep the odd sentence, even though it is incomplete.
So once I get to the Isle of the Beast, I can show that the string of
Alexander
letters
pulls out his magic map.
Dangling participle and pick it up and get the rare book. So let me go ahead and
Alexander
that.
Feels a strange pulling sensation.
Oh, he's not here yet. Well,
Alexander pulls out his magic map. Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
I guess I have to talk to the bookworm first. I can't do that until I do this.
Alexander picks the flower and is startled by its hideously strong skunk-like odor. For a moment, he can smell nothing else. Alexander takes the feather.
All right. Now, I know the solution to the
Alexander
wall,
pulls out his magic map.
For now. Go back to that
Alexander line. Feels a strange pulling sensation.
Alright. Start to walk this way.
Alexander hears someone coming.
Five guards. Each one of them has a quirk of, like a main sense, like...
Five fierce guards of the isle we be. Watch for a foreign man, said he. With ears and nose, tongue, hands, and eyes, its nature cannot be disguised. If man it be, then man it dies.
First one, smell.
Old Tom Troll, smell your smell. Do that which you do so well.
That's what I need the flower for.
Alexander holds the flower of stench out to the gnome with the jumbo nose.
Tom Troll I am, that's all I'll be. My nose knows all on land and sea. A flower of stench has washed ashore. A flower, 'tis all, and nothing more.
Next is sound.
Listen, hark you, Grovenor. Do your duty as you swore. With your ears, please tell us more.
This is where I need the nightingale.
Alexander winds the tin nightingale.
But he doesn't hear the winding.
The gnome with the monumental ears.
Or just chooses to ignore it.
A nose is not a way to spy. My ears cannot be told a lie. A nightingale is all there be. No man is near, and so say me.
Taste, Rumm Trump, that we might know whether the friend or whether the foe.
Alright, this one is the taste, so I need the mint for this.
Alexander holds the mint out for the gnome with the gigantic mouth.
Grump Flump knows a tasty treat. It matters not what others bleat. No danger is this one so
mouth.
Sweet.
Trilly Dilly, use your hands. Is it beast or is it man?
This one is the lucky rabbit's foot.
Alexander holds the rabbit foot out for the gnome with the huge hands.
Be all you mad? What aileth thee? A bunny can't trill merrily. A hare does not at all taste sweet. A rabbit here is all we greet.
Old Bill Batter, never fatter. Vision can resolve this matter. Look you now, and end this chatter!
Alright, this is why I need to go back to the ink bottle.
Boop. Alexander pours the contents of the empty-looking ink bottle over himself.
By all that's beauteous, fair, and sightly, four morons do I sleep with nightly. There's nothing there at all, I say. Enough of this. Let's now away!
Do you sleep with four morons?
Alexander did it. He's fooled the guards.
All right, now I can go over here. They won't be coming back. Let me talk to the Black Widow.
Wow. Hiya, gorgeous. What a luscious-looking hunk of flesh you are.
Thank you, I guess. Who are you?
How charming of you to pretend not to know. I'm Black Widow, of course. The femme fatale of all femme fatales. Know what I mean?
Scarlett,
you know, I was just thinking it was time I found my 50th, another husband. It would be quite a horror, I mean, an honor to have me as a bride. Just look at my beautiful weaving. It's so light, so delicate. You'll never want to leave my little nest.
It is a lovely web. But my heart is elsewhere, I'm afraid.
Oh, drat! I mean, the loss is yours. I'm sure you'll change your mind once you consider the advantages.
Hey! Don't touch that thread!
Alexander snatches the scrap of parchment, curious to see what's written on it.
Blue and red. Border.
The wind blows the scrap of paper from Alexander's hand, but he remembers what it said well enough.
All right, let me try to grab a book here. Doesn't matter which one.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm sorry. I didn't realize these books had an owner. I'm in need of a rare book.
No owner. All books have owners, my good man. And this book owner, bookworm to you, wouldn't part with one of his books for anything.
Isn't there something I can do for you to pay for the book?
Let's see. Do you have an itinerant clause?
No. No clauses at all, I'm afraid.
As an exception, you always should!
Oxymoron. And diphthong.
Don't mind oxymoron and diphthong. They're fairly limited grammatical principles, you know. Let's see. A marsh pig that does Texas?
No. I'm afraid not.
A dangling participle?
And there it is.
I'm fresh out.
A purple fiddle whacker?
No, I don't think so. Sorry.
An idiosyncrasy, perhaps?
Afraid not.
Ha! Then what good are you?
Alright, now I can go get the dangling participle, but first, there's a couple things I can do up here now. One is the milk from the milkweed bush.
Alexander takes a bottle of milk from the milkweed bush.
The dogwood tree doesn't like that.
Apparently, the dogwood tree doesn't like Alexander standing that close.
Next, I can get some iceberg lettuce and the rotten tomato.
Hey! What do you think you're doing there? Get your hands off me! Hey!
Alexander picks up rotten tomato and puts him away. One never knows when one will need a rotten tomato.
Now, funnily enough, I can talk to him.
Where were you born, a barn? It's a pigsty back here! Yeah! All this stuff you got! What do you want to carry all this trash around for? I got a lawyer, you know! Yeah! There's kidnapping laws in this here kingdom! I got a lawyer, you know!
And yeah. Alright, now I can get
Alexander
some,
picks a...
iceberg lettuce.
Ye gads! Is that cold?
And go through here. Try to move forward, but it won't let me.
Checkmate!
Only chess pieces allowed in chessboard land. That's right. Humans aren't allowed in and never will be. Stay out!
And that triggers the queens.
I must insist, Your Highness. I shall send the lump of coal to the Wizier and the Princess as a present for their wedding, and that's the end of it.
And I suppose you'll leave me with only this stupid spoiled egg to send, Your Highness. I want to impress the new King and Queen of the realm as much as you do. As Queen of this island, I have every right to that lump of coal.
Who isn't queen of this isle? The lump of coal is in my possession. Therefore, I shall do as I please with it. Besides, there's nothing wrong with that spoiled egg.
The egg, though delightfully spoiled, is not nearly so valuable as the lump of coal, and you know it. Your Highness always got to carry the singing stone. It's not fair that you get the coal, too.
That doesn't count. The singing stone was stolen by that horrid beast. I should get to keep the coal just because my stone was stolen.
It wasn't your stone. It belonged to the Isle of Wonder Treasury. Your Highness always thinks that everything is hers.
Excuse me, my good man, but could you settle an argument for us?
Which of us should get to carry the coal and which the egg? Remember, white is the color of deserving truth and virtue.
Quiet, Your Highness, and let him make up his own mind. I, for one, shall be more proper, and not even mention the fact that red is the color of love.
I'm sorry, Your Majesties. I'm partial to both red and white. But I'm afraid that I don't know how to solve your problem. One of you will just have to be gracious and allow the other the lump of coal.
What a ridiculously stupid idea!
Quite ludicrous.
He was a lot of help, wasn't he?
Oh, yes. Obviously a man of high intelligence.
Now, later on, I'll need that,
The lump of coal goes much better with my gown anyway. Black and red are imperial colors.
I'll need the egg for a spell.
That's the silliest thing I ever heard. Red does not go with anything, being much too self-conscious. White is the perfect accompaniment to any color.
Oh, not yet. There it goes. I'm gonna grab that.
Alexander picks up the Red Queen's scarf.
Now I'll use that whenever I face off against the Minotaur. Spoilers. I could try to grab the hole in wall, but I don't have the item I need to grab it yet. I can go to
Alexander pulls out his magic map.
Isle of the Beast.
Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Hello, friend. Aren't you an odd-looking little fellow?
I'm not odd-looking, you are!
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you could speak.
Speak not? Funny is. Speech I am and nothing but.
You speak strangely, friend.
Strange? My speech is not eloquence I speak with.
But who are you? And why are you here?
Away I fly my home from. Lost I am, therefore. As my name, too, can you guess not? It's what I do this branch with, and the way I speak of.
Go ahead and
Alexander holds the sentence out to the creature.
This sentence seems in need of an ending. Perhaps you could finish it?
Where are you going? Where are you going? Know what I do? Where are you going to? Like you, I do. Go I with you?
Well, that was certainly interesting. It looks like Alexander now has a passenger.
Two now. If you count the Rotten Tomato. Let me talk to him real quick.
Take me home to!
Okay, I guess that's all he says. Oh, I better go. The iceberg lettuce is melting.
Hoping to cool down the boiling pond, Alexander throws in a head of iceberg lettuce. The pond's water slowly stops boiling, cooled by the ice. It still looks hot, but bearable.
All right, walk across.
Alexander decides to brave the steaming pond.
Ouch! Ow! Ouch!
The pond is no longer boiling, but it's hardly bathwater.
Okay, now I can grab the lamp.
Alexander takes the old hunter's lamp from the tree.
Now, you can rub the lamp, but it won't do anything.
Alexander rubs the lamp, but nothing happens.
Alright, now, let's see.
As Alexander continues down the path, he gets the strange feeling that he's being watched.
Come on over here and see what I'm doing with these flowers. Never mind that stone fella on top of the gate. He won't hurt you any. He's just there to scare you.
Alright. As I said before, I'm going to save the game and do anything the genie says. One more thing. Come on. Right in the neck.
Gotcha this time. Tickets up. Next.
That move was slightly erroneous.
Pawns. Alright. Need the brick. That's
Alexander picks up the brick.
Solution to a puzzle later.
You aren't gonna listen to me, are you?
I already did.
Well, we'll just see about that.
That's odd. The gardener just disappeared.
Alright. Let's see, I have the dangling participles, so I can go ahead and...
Alexander pulls out his magic map. Right. Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Skip talking again, just go straight to the...
Hello, Bookworm. I have something you might be interested in.
Well, what is it this time?
I found this little fellow lost on another island.
Coming home, I am too.
There you are, you naughty boy. I told you not to leave the island.
Glad I am seeing you too.
A most solemn celebration!
Meow.
So, you found my dangling participle. I suppose I'll have to give you something. Let's see now. Was it a rare book you wanted?
Yes, sir.
Well, then none of these will do. They've been sitting in the sun far too long and must be well cooked by now.
Ha.
This one is far more rare. A delicious little tidbit.
Thanks.
Now, the last time I did a... tried to go for a perfect run, I forgot to look at the book. So...
Alexander is carrying a rare book from the bookworm. The words in the binding are very faint. The something-something riddle book. Alexander opens the rare book and looks inside. The book contains riddles and has a page missing. Alexander glances at a few of the conundrums, but finds himself more curious about the one that is missing. What was the riddle, he wonders? More importantly, what was the answer?
So that's where the answer from the Black Widow's web was. So we know the answer, we just don't know the riddle. Which, I kind of already know the riddle. But I'm going to save that for another time. For now, it's time to go back to the Isle of the Crown.
Alexander pulls out his magic map. Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Now, to continue on to the Isle of the Sacred Mountain, I will need the hole in the wall and the lamp, or lantern. To get the hole in the wall, I need to use the flute. First... That's new. Let's take a look.
Alexander doesn't remember that sign being on the wall before. He decides to take a closer look. It's a proclamation. It reads, "Citizens rejoice, announcing the royal wedding and coronation of Wazir Abdul Al-Hazred and Princess Kasima. For reasons of security, the wedding will not be open to the public. Long live the new king and queen of the land of the Green Isles." Alexander feels his stomach turn at the thought of the dread event. If he doesn't do something soon, Kasima will be another man's wife.
Go into Ali's books. Nice.
Jalo, how fare you? And what news have you from the castle?
Prince Alex, how I fare is close to boiling. Have you seen the wedding proclamations around the village? I've heard rumors of the wedding, of course, but I didn't want to believe it, and I never thought it would be so soon.
Kasima. Married. Oh, it is an unpleasant thing to swallow, friend. If only I knew Kasima wished it. Tell me about the wazir, Jalo.
The wazir? Now there's a dangerous subject. His name is Abdul Al-Hazred. He came to the kingdom 15 years ago. The king was fascinated by his knowledge and his fine-sounding ideas. It didn't take long for Al-Hazred to convince the king to trust him with the minor problems of daily government. You see, Caliphim had a wife and a new daughter he wanted to spend time with. Al-Hazred became wazir.
And now?
Well, he's had his eye on Kasima ever since she was a young girl. And she is the only thing between him and the throne.
That's not
Do you
cool.
think he means to harm her?
Oh, I honestly don't know. I think he'd rather keep her as wife. But whatever his plans for the princess, he will use her to his best advantage. That's his way.
Perhaps he has charmed her. Perhaps she cares for him now.
The Wazir is capable of anything, and Cosima must be vulnerable and lonely right now. Still, she has always instinctively distrusted him. Cosima has a good head on her shoulders. I'd be surprised if she's truly fallen for his words of love. I must return to the castle, Prince Alex, and you to your wanderings. May we both fare well.
Let me go ahead and give him the book while I'm here.
I found this rare book, and I thought of your offer.
Very interesting. It is a wonderful riddle book. Riddles are much more marketable than spells these days. I guess people believe more in mirth than in magic. Here is the spell book you wanted, and a fair trade it is, I must say. Enjoy it.
I certainly hope so. We shall see how rusty my spell casting truly is.
All right, now I can take a look at the spell book. Where is it? There it is. Swamp ooze, river sticks water, and black horse feather. I have the feather. I get that in the Isle of, or Land of the Dead, and I get that when I use the rotten tomato. Future of salt water, not from the sea. That's what the milkweed bush bottle is for. From the baby's tears. Vial of sacred water. I get that from the oracle after the labyrinth. And falling water. That would be rain. Skull full of hot oak embers. I get the skull in the labyrinth. The sulfur or brimstone. That's the rotten egg. Strand of the pure-hearted maiden's hair. There's two ways I can get that. I can get that from either Cosima or from Beauty, from when she no longer uses her.
This is the last page.
Robes or whatever. Now, other than Jalo, there's nothing I really need in Ali's shop anymore.
Your candy dish is empty.
I am sorry, sir, but I have no more mints. Somebody has eaten them all.
Well, get some more then.
I fear that is impossible. Without the fairy, I can no longer get imports from the other islands, and we do not grow mint extract on the Isle of the Crown.
Oh, I hate not getting what I want.
Alright. Let's see, I need the flute.
Would you mind if I traded this in?
Of course, Prince Alex. Please, choose something in exchange for the items on the counter.
Alexander looks closely at the items on the counter to make his selection.
Flute it is.
I'll take the flute.
The flute? Very good, Prince Alex. May its music always be sweet. Feel free to trade it back at any time.
Thank you.
All right, now I can give him the pearl.
I found this large pearl. Might it be valuable enough to ransom back my family ring?
I have never seen such a perfect pearl. Certainly you can have your ring back.
Oh, I'm glad you didn't sell it. I'm a bit attached to it, I'm afraid.
Of course you are. You would be cold-hearted if you felt any differently. I am happy to see a family heirloom back with its rightful owner.
Alright, I think that's all I need from him for now. Go ahead and give the ring to Sing Sing. Alright. Let's see, I'm at 72 of 231. Let me go ahead and save this for now. Save often. I'm not saving enough. Let's see. Ring to Sing Sing. Poet didn't know it. Alright. Here we go.
Alexander holds out his insignia ring to the Nightingale, hoping she perhaps is the Nightingale that Jallo spoke of, and that she might be able to take the ring to Cosima. The ring is the one thing he has that might alert Cosima to his presence on the Isles. The Nightingale swoops down and grabs the ring. She flies off towards the castle, perhaps to Cosima?
Sing Sing, what have you got in your mouth, my pretty? A gold ring? Sing Sing, where did you get this? Realm of Daventry. But this is Alexander's ring. Oh, my soul, he must be here. Sing Sing, I wish you could tell me what you've seen. Is he really here, then, on this very island? Oh, if only I could leave this castle as easily as you. Take this ribbon, Sing Sing. If you know where he is, return it to him. Please be careful, Alexander. It is so dangerous, and yet I could not wish you away.
The little bird makes a delivery.
Yay!
It's a red velvet hair ribbon. Could it be? Could it possibly belong to Cosima herself?
Or am I merely wishing it were so? Oh.
Alright, let's see if it's in there.
Alexander examines the red ribbon and finds a strand of long black hair.
Alright, next is the poem.
Alexander holds out the love poem, hoping that the bird will deliver it to the same place she took the ring, in the chance that the receiver might truly be Cosima. The Nightingale swoops down, grabs the love poem, and takes it towards the castle.
Sing Sing, my sweet, you bring another present. Let me see. It is a poem, Sing Sing.
What was it when I looked at you? What power has chained me through and through, and binds my heart with links so tight, I cannot live without the sight of you.
At least it doesn't go through the whole thing.
Oh, Alexander. I was hoping he'd return to you. Take this to him while he waits. Hurry, my fleet one.
The little bird makes a delivery.
Now, strangely enough, the last time I played this, those little cutscenes didn't happen. For some reason, I think they've updated the game on GOG since then.
It's a note.
Dearest Alexander, I cannot believe you are here, my friend. Please, please be careful. Abdul isn't about to let anyone interfere with his plans. Watch out for Abdul's genie, Alexander, and do not do anything rash. I am not without resources, and I will prevail if I can only find some small means of defense. Do nothing to try to get to me. You must not be endangered again for my sake. Greatly in your family's debt, Cosima.
Alexander's hand trembles as he reads the note. For the first time in his long search, he has heard her voice again, if only in writing. No words of love, only friendly concern. Friend. Is the maiden merely shy, or does she regard him only as a brother?
Alexander got friend zoned. That's more of a precaution to just so that if the note ever got intercepted. All right, now that I have the flute, I can go to...
Alexander pulls out his magic map.
Get the hole in the wall.
Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
While I'm there, there's a couple things I can get. First off, there should be a teacup here on the table. Oh, it's on the chair. There it is. Go ahead and grab the teacup.
Alexander would love to sit a sp-
Oops. There we go.
Alexander takes the teacup.
If I attempt to take
Alexander
the hole in the
decides
wall.
To pick up the hole in the wall. A hole in the wall could be a very useful thing. Alexander startled the poor thing. It's run off to hide behind the wallflowers.
Ha. Alright, now I can play the flute for the wallflowers.
May I have this dance?
Oh, my!
My RAM in my modern computer is too fast for the Snapdragons.
Alexander stops playing the flute, but the wallflowers and Snapdragons continue to dance, caught up in the music and oblivious to everything around them. While the wallflowers dance, Alexander snatches the hole in the wall.
Alright, now I just need the lantern, or the lamp, or... No, I have the lamp. It's the lantern that I need. That reminds me, I do need to fill the lamp while I'm here. Here.
Alexander gives one of the baby's tears a bottle of milk. The other baby's tears seem to resent Alexander's gift for some reason.
That will be salt water, not from the sea.
Alexander collects some of the baby's tears in the old hunter's lamp.
Alright. Now, it doesn't matter what I collect. It's all, none of this is what I need. What I need is over here with the stick in the mud. And just collecting...
That would serve no purpose.
Oh, whoops. Collecting any of this, we'll start a little cutscene.
What do you think you're doing?
You startled me. I was just getting some swamp ooze.
Well, you certainly won't get it there! That's not swamp ooze! That's swamp muck!
Oh, I was gonna say slime.
That's he's
right,
right
slime,
you know.
Is in the,
but he could be a little nicer about telling you. He's not a very pleasant stick in the mud.
Nobody asked you! Be quiet!
Oh, the trials of being a mere bump on a log.
I say that a lot.
Perhaps you could toss me some swamp ooze, since you seem to be able to recognize it. I can only reach this bit by the path.
Well, hoity-toity, look who's Mr. Want-So-Much! You think I got a job here passing around precious swamp matter? You should be so lucky!
He's an utter waste of oxygen. I'd save my breath if I were you.
Alright, now... Yeah, I can give him the... Or the bump on the log, the, Rotten Tomato.
I thought this might come in handy the next time your brother starts picking on you.
Aha! Finally, old Bump on the Log's not so defenseless, is he?
Hey! Hey! What are you doing there? Watch the pulp, would you? Now, Bumpy, remember all I've given you!
The only thing you've ever given me is mud! Take this!
No! Not into the swamp!
Oh, and it crashed. I guess I'll just call that there. Thanks for watching, and I'll try to pick back up where I left off.